Are we live? What are you doing?
We've been live for a while.
Now we are.
No, we were live before that. Okay. Hey, everybody. How are you? I'm done speaking. This is your live.
You said you were going to prompt me.
Okay. Hey, everybody. How are you? It's Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training, and I want to start featuring Joelle because Joelle actually does, she's our social media manager, and she actually is going to start doing social media tips, and she also does social media Skype, so you can book a Skype with her. But what I really want to do is start, again, going along with our whole philosophy and everything we do is giving away as much information as possible as we can so you will succeed. So this is across the board for dog owners, for business owners. This does not make a difference what business. Don't worry, Joelle will talk, but she needs prompting.
I know, you're just like...
But this goes across the board no matter what business you are. So what I want to talk about today, let's really start focusing this, and I put it in the title, IG stories, Instagram stories.
Mm.
Like, let's what we're
so important.
So guys, all your Q&A should be on stories.
Which way is the camera facing right now? Is it on your face or mine?
It's always on your face.
Oh.
Okay, of course.
Look professional, Joelle.
So when do I stop picking my nose? By the way, on IG stories, you could pick your nose.
I could.
So let's talk about IG stories.
Okay. So stories are like, it's like the bread and butter of Instagram. It lets your audience know you on a personal level. And that's, I feel like, is how you build like your know, like, and trust. Because people feel like they already have a relationship with you and they know you. And it's not just the business side of things. It's like, where's your favorite place to go out? What are your hobbies? Oh, I don't know. Joelle likes to eat a plant-based diet. Like, all these little things that you relate to people with that they wouldn't normally see on, like, your day-to-day feed.
Mm.
So, like...
Can you explain stories? Like literally, like, they disappear. And can you just explain stories and explain, like, where they are? Like, some people might not even know stories.
So on Instagram, like, in the circle where your little icon is, that's where, like, your stories hang out. Or if you swipe left on your home screen, it'll bring you there. Stories are up for 24 hours only. So that's why you can put a lot of, like, the fun stuff up there, because they're not, like, they're not there to permanently, like, muck up your feed. They go away. And it keeps that constant engagement going because people have to constantly keep going back to check them before they disappear. So it's a way to bring in engagement. It's a way to, like, build your community. And it's a way for your fans to just, like, get to know you.
Right.
On a personal level.
Right. From a business standpoint, and when I say business, that doesn't mean making money. It means, but just from a know, like, and trust standpoint, it's the kind of thing where someone could go, How do I get somebody to show up at my page every day? Do stories, because they keep disappearing.
Yep.
So
you can hashtag in there. You can tag your location. So, like, you can still do all the things you would do on Instagram in your stories. You can add music. Like, you can make it really fun. You can add little gifts. Like, you can get really creative. I love stories.
Right. Technically, it's like Snapchat, but stolen.
Yeah.
Right.
Basically. Not as good as filters, but.
Right. Right. But they're starting to do more and more filters now. Mm-hmm. Which is interesting, yeah.
It's fun. It's interactive.
Right. So there's a couple of different theories out there. I think what a lot of people are probably uncomfortable doing is being personal on their business page.
Yeah.
Now, I try to actually do everything non... So let's just talk about ourselves. Like, how do we utilize our stories?
I don't think we have rules.
Right.
We put everything on
stories. There we go. That's it right there.
Yeah. Like,
that's the rule. That's
there's no rules.
Our company policy, at least, I mean, you and I and one or two key staff members control stories, mm-hmm. but mostly you control stories, and I'll just randomly do stories too. But I think the rule is, there's sort of no rules.
No. So when I first started doing your social, my goal with stories was to show the funny, like, the stuff that people don't really see from the day-to-day, like the goofiness that goes on in the office, the funny stuff Angelo does, or like bloopers from training sessions, like the stuff that people don't normally see.
Right, right. Anything, now we should say there's no rules, but there actually are rules.
Yeah.
What are some things that people should, not necessarily have to, but should stay away from on all of social media, frankly?
But politics.
Right, politics.
Religion.
Yep.
What else? Sports teams.
Yeah, well, I mean, believe it or not, so politics and religion, definitely.
Yeah.
I think you've got to make a firm decision if you want to dabble in sexual orientation, but all depends on how you portray that. If you go into like, you know, slanderous or political on sexual orientation, you got to be really careful. And then also, believe it or not, sports, you might alienate like a lot of people. Yeah. But then again, you can always have the FM attitude if they don't like it, that I like a certain sports team or not.
Yeah.
So what else do you want to talk about stories? Like, what are some things that, why do you think people don't want to do stories?
Because it's FaceTime. It depends. Like, we do a lot of like FaceTime on stories. You don't have to though. You can post other things.
A photo.
Yeah, but people probably shy away from it because it allows people to see you on a more personal level. And everybody likes to, like, hide behind the screen a little bit. I get it.
Like yourself,
yeah.
Who's sweating right now doing your stories.
I'm literally sweating.
Right.
I have pit stains.
That's right. No, you're not.
But, like,
that's why I'm wearing a jacket. So, yes. So I think that one of the things that I share, especially with my interns, like, we just got a new intern from Canada, and you and I went through this a year and a half ago,
yeah.
Is, number one, stop caring what people think.
Mm-hmm.
And I think most people, they care too much what people think, and it's like, listen, that doesn't give you permission to be a jerk or slanderous or you know, rude or impolite, and people are like, well, geez, Jeff, you're rude and impolite. It's like, okay, well, whatever. fuck you. I don't care what you think. So I think one of the biggest things, takeaways, I think, from doing stories, even though this is your tip, I'm like sort of like
that's
jumping
fine.
Back and you forth, is show who you are. And here's a great example. Angelo, get over here. Come over here, honey. Will you say hi to the Instagram audience? We're doing IG stories. Say hello.
Hi.
Okay, get out of here. Bye. Like, literally, like,
away.
It's like that. It's like,
yeah.
Like, oh my God, he just yelled at his kid. It's like, please. If you watch this long enough, you'll know that, like, I'm not yelling at Angelo. Angelo comes to work, he homeschools. It's like, stuff like that. Like, you do things like that. You do, you know, do things that you normally wouldn't do on your normal feed.
We posted you getting pedicures.
Yeah.
Believe it or not, there's a lot of people who are like, hey, I get pedicures too.
Yeah, mani-pedi. It's a great conversation starter,
yes.
Because then it disappears.
Yeah.
Yes. Yeah.
Yeah. It's just a way for people to feel like they know you a little bit more.
Yeah.
Which is important.
I think that's
when you're trying to build a community.
That's a big thing.
Yeah.
It's a great thing. Great. So that's it. So, guys, utilize stories. If you don't know how to do stories, there's a great website out there. If everybody wants to write this down right now, there's two websites that we always recommend.
Here we go.
GOOGLE.com, okay? Or you can go to YOUTUBE, and you go to those websites, and you can actually just type in,
everything.
How do I do Instagram stories? How do I do Instagram stories? Awesome. What else do you want to say about them? Anything else? Any questions, guys? Any questions at all? No? Okay.
Cool.
Awesome. Thank you guys so much. And Joelle, thanks for doing your first live where you are featured in front of the camera.
You're welcome.
Talking directly.
Yeah. And looking at it.
Right.
I've come a long way.
Being put on the hot spot.
Yep.
Hot seat. So let's go with that. Mm-hmm. How have you come a long way?
I don't think I would have been able to get a word out a year ago.
Just be me putting you in the hot
being
seat.
Being on live, like, right. By myself. Yeah.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah. Yeah. In a way,
I can't think of anything impromptu.
Yeah. But I think you're doing great. You're doing great. So thank you all for watching. Joelle, thank you for getting out of your comfort zone. And Joelle's going to be doing these at least once a week. And also, people can do a social media Skype with her.
Wes.
Which would be much different because she can analyze your social media and help you all out. All right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, bye.